Good evening, everyone. In the high volume production system, we have come into the last topic, that is the buffer storage. So before that, we are going to discuss about the some of the common reason for the line stoppages are here. So due to the tool failure or tool adjustment, we are going to stop the flow lines, and also for tool changing also we are going to stop the flow lines, because if you are going to stop change the tools over in the workstations, so definitely are going to stop the flow lines. Then comes into the some of the defective work parts or components of the assembly station, which requires to feed the mechanism be cleared. So that means the defective parts has to be taken out from the assembly lines, and feed hoppers need to be replenished at an assembly station. And sometimes maybe in the electrical switches malfunctioning also, those times to repairing that one, we are going to stop the flow lines. Then comes into the mechanical failures of transfer system or workstations, we are going to stop the flow lines. Up to the repairing the particular system, we are going to stop the flow lines. So these are all the reasons for we are going to stop the flow lines. Then comes into the buffer storage. So buffer storage is the temporary storage that is provided in the flow line itself, okay, and also it will be act as a storage or in the system. So when it will be useful for the buffer storage means, suppose in the flow line some 6, 4, 5, 1, 2, 7 machines are connected over here. So those times what happens in, suppose fourth number of machines it got the problem, some struck means, what happens, the first, second, third machines will be working over there. So those times without stopping the those three machines, it is a process that will be takes place, and also fourth machine has to be repairing work has to be takes place. So those times what happens in the first three machine, the products continuously it will be producing over here, that it will be stored in the flow line itself. In those times the buffer storage are helpful to storing the product and also continuously running the other machines. So for that purpose the buffer storage has to be used here. Then in the continuous intermittent system acts a single integrated machine. Already we know that intermittent system is the like the same time all the component has to be transferred into the next consecutive workstations. Suppose in the first machine, first workstation, the cycle time will be the 1 minute. The second workstation, it will be the cycle time will be the 2 minutes. Means what happens in the first machine, it has to produce two components, but in the second machine, it will going to produce in the only one component. Those times, what happens? So the extra one component, it will be where to stay in the flow line only. So those times, the flow line it will be act as a buffer storage over here. Okay, so that it will be very helpful to storing the unfinished component in the flow line itself. So suppose sometime we need to transfer from the flow lines, means what happens, again the component it will be takes from the flow line, it will be placed over in some other place. Whenever it required, again it will be transferred to the flow lines. So it will be take time, unnecessary work, and also the power usage it will be required more. So avoid that one, the buffer storage, it will be helping the production systems. Okay, then comes into the see in this drawing there are showing the buffer storage system. So there are some four machines will be connected over here, another four machines will be there. So the component has to be stored or comes over here and performs the work, and it will be moves over here like this manner. So so many components has to be stored over in the flow lines itself. Okay, suppose these machines cycle time it will be more like a 2 minutes, but this machine cycle time will be 1.5 minutes, okay, so that sorry, 1 minute. So that what happens, this minutes working time, this will be produce the two components. Okay, so that what happens, those two extra components will be stored over here itself. Okay, that will be helping. So it will be transferred from here, it takes place, more energy to be required, waste of time. So those things and all avoid with help of the buffer storage. Okay, and this is for using this buffer storage to reduce the effect of station breakdown. On those times it will be used, the other workstation continuously working over there. So in those times it will be helped to provide the bank of power supply the line, to provide the place and the output of the line, to allow the curing time or other required delay if it may be request some curing time, and to smooth cycle time variation, and to store the parts between stages with a different production rate. So the disadvantages of the buffer storage will be the flow lines are increased factory floor space, and higher process inventory, and more material handling equipment, and greater complexity of the overall flow line system. So these are all the disadvantages of the buffer storage, like flow, it requires more space, and process inventory it will be increases, and material handling equipment it required more, and greater complexity of the overall flow lines. So then comes into the work part transfer methods. There are three type of work part transfer methods are there. One is the continuous work part transfer method, second one will be the intermittent work part transfer method, and third one will be the asynchronous transfer work part method. So continuous means the flow line it will be continuously moves, means that is called it as continuous work part transfer method. It is need not to wait for anything. Okay, that is work continuous work part transfer method. Suppose if your people are gone into the aerodrome, okay, so those times the luggages it comes, no, so it will keep on rotating over there. They okay, over the particular bags and other things, they will be take care of that, so it will not stop over there. So like that is the continuous work part transfer method. So the continuous work part transfer method, there are small components it will be placed over here, mainly in the assembling work they will be done in the continuous work part transfer method. Then comes into the intermittent method, like a walking beam mechanism. In the walking beam mechanism, what happens, the entire component, suppose this is the four machines are there, so here the transfer beam is there, it will be goes and picks over into the all the component, it will be moves on, place onto the next successive workstations. That is called transfer mechanism. That means all the component has to be transferred at the same time towards to the next consecutive workstations, successive workstations. That is the intermittent workstation, or in the synchronous work part transfer method. Asynchronous means suppose this component has to be finished for this particular workstation, this has to be moved into the second station, it will be the independent. Whenever the second workstation has to be finished, this has to be moved on to the third workstation. Like that it will be moves, means that is called it as asynchronous method. Okay, so these are the three types of workstation work part transfer methods are available. So with that, this first module has to be get over.